tell us about this project. What are you doing? A lot of comics are taking their stuff online. They can't get to clubs. They can't get to theaters. They can't ply their trade with everything shut down. So you got a Facebook show, Josh Wolf's Wonderful World of Weird. What is it?
Yeah, man, it's just that. You know, I like weird things. I like making people uncomfortable. I like being made uncomfortable, but all in fun. And so what I did is I had the producers of this show make a list of just weird things. And then I said, this is what I'd like to try. This is what I'd like to try. And I didn't want to know anything else. And so when I showed up to places, I get to be surprised along with the people who are watching. On the first episode, they put a leech on my butthole.
Well, I'm sorry.
What?
Like Stand By Me style, when they come out of the bog and they got leeches all over their junk, you put one on the service entrance?
Yeah. I
guess so. For what? Yeah, what is the point?
What isn't the point?
What else do we have to do right now? I mean, really, it's not like we got anywhere to be. We might as well place a leech on our, you know, asshole right now. I mean, what else do we have to do?
That's my point of view. I mean, what else? I mean, most of the days, I'm assuming you don't have a leech on your butthole, right?
Yeah.
But why not make it up one day?
Yeah.
That's a good way to look at it,
Hey, on
right?
The second episode, Josh Wolf slams his balls at a car door because we got nothing else to do.
It's comedian Josh Wolf joining us on the phone. He's been in studio with us a whole bunch. He's been to McGoobies a gazillion times. You might know him from Chelsea Lately. And you were doing the things where you'd go out into your backyard and just set up a camera, get stoned out of your mind, and just do – what was that called? Are you still doing those?
Yeah, I did that last night. It's called the High Live. I added some mushrooms into it last night.
Oh, jeez. Thank God.
Guys, it was amazing. And so right now, part of the High Lives, I'm reading children's books. So I'll get super high and I'll take some mushrooms and then I'll read children's books. Okay. And I was reading this book last night called Walter the Farting Dog. And you guys, have you ever read this series of books?
No. But I will be purchasing it today. Okay.
Let me tell you something. This Walter fella gets himself into some real sticky situations. But
there he was, Walter's trying to hide from the farmer as he was in his corn crop, but then poor Walter. Uh-oh, he heard Walter, the farting dog.
You guys, I'm telling you, these books, especially when you're a little bit high, and you don't, I mean, I've never read them before, so when you're a little bit high, you know, some of the, there's this one book called Walter the Farting Dog, Trouble at the Yard Sale, okay? Walter is just, his farts are just worse, right? So last night, Walter is at the tag sale, and the father's not selling anything. Out on his table to sell it. It's a community yard sale, right? So all the neighbors are out. But the father has, like, no joke, in the illustration, on the table, an old set of teeth, some old tidy whities, and like an old sailboat. That was it. There are these weird, tidy whities just sitting out on this table.
Oh,
I'm looking at it. And then you know what Walter, you know what the dad did? Well, he sold Walter for $10. The kid's dog. This is a kid's book, guys. He sells the dog for $10 to this clown who hooks him up to a machine called the Fart Catcher. And then he uses...
Fart Catcher.
Wait. And then he uses... Well, he hooks Walter's beehole up to balloons, and he fills these balloons up with farts, and he robs banks. He robs banks with these fart-filled balloons. It's the weirdest kid's look.
Oh, my God.
What are you talking about?
I just got on Amazon.
Look at this. There's a whole bunch of them.
I just ordered Walter the Farting Dog Gets Banned from the Beach.
Walter, that was my first one, dude.
I just started Walter the Farting Dog. I can't wait. Oh, my God. Again, Josh Wolf joining us. Please check out the guy's video on the 98 Rock YouTube page. The Rhino Story's a 10. Watch the Facebook show, Josh Wolf's Wonderful World of Weird, where you can see a leech on his asshole. If that isn't a sales point right there, it should just be a black background, white font. Josh Wolf puts a leech on his hole.
I don't want you to spoil anything, Josh Wolf, but
does a leech end up on your hole?
Is enjoyable?
Well, I mean, define enjoyable. When it first attaches itself, it's not comfortable. But you know, then you forget it's there, and then you know what was weird is every now it was cold and damp, and it would wiggle around and it would tickle a little bit. You know, it's sensitive down there, you know. So I have to take the leech home because the leech did things that only my wife has ever done. So I figured it was only right to bring the leech home.
Oh my god! And introduce it to the missus. Like, there's someone I need you to meet, honey. We are in love.
I didn't want to just discard it. Like, I didn't know it. That seemed callous and hard.
Yeah,
and I didn't
you
want
could
to
just
do that.
Use it like that. And well, just, yeah, that's not right.
The next time you get to get your ass in studio, I need you to bring that leech with us. All right. And we're going to place it on my live on air because I kind of need to know because it's been, let's just say, below the belt, been real dusty since this quarantine got kicked off. And at this point, I might consider having a leech betwixt my butt cheeks just to feel anything from being trapped inside.
Just to feel. Just to feel.
I will tell you, if you really are that desperate, I will order you a leech and send it to you.
All right. I'm putting Josh Wolf on hold at the end of this, and you are going to give him all of our contact information, and he is going to mail us a mobile tongue because I need to feel literally anything.
I just want you to, as long as you name the leech Matt Damon before you put it on your beehole.
Deal.